Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome in our biology session. So we are discussing our lesson, that is what? Microorganism, friend and foe. Okay, in that we have discussed about the different groups of a microorganisms. So today we will move for the next point and a new point from the lesson, that is nothing but what? Useful microorganisms. Okay, so there are the so many microorganisms are present on the earth. Among them, some microorganisms are useful to us. Okay, so today we'll discuss about the useful microorganisms to make the different food items. Okay, so from the useful microorganisms, there are the certain microorganisms which are used to make a different food items. Okay, so in that today we will see the first one example, that is what? Lactobacillus bacteria help make curd from milk. Okay, so the Lactobacillus bacteria helps to make a curd from milk. Okay, so let's see how the exactly Lactobacillus bacteria helps to form a curd from milk. Okay, so curd can be happens, or we can make a curd when the casein protein is present in a milk. Okay, so the casein protein, if there is a casein protein present in a milk, then only the we can form a curd, or then only the formation of curd is happens. Why this is happens? Because if the casein protein is present in the milk, then what happen? The milks can get, or that protein can get clumps together to form a solidified mass. Okay, to form a curd, it is necessary that casein protein is present in a milk. Okay, so if that, because of that, what happen? The casein protein can get clumps together. Okay, that is only we are calling as what? Clumps together, and then it forms a solidified mass. Okay, then it forms the solidified mass. That process is only also called as what? Coagulation. Okay, so that solidified mass comes together, that casein proteins comes together in the form of solidified mass, and that process is called as what? Coagulation. Okay, again I will repeat, student, keep in your mind that the curd can be prepared if there is a casein protein present in a milk. Why? Because that casein protein can clumps together to form a solidified mass. Okay, that casein protein comes together. Okay, clumps means that small portions comes together and it becomes solidified mass, and that process is called as what? Coagulation. That process is only called as what? Coagulation. But to form that coagulation, that casein protein required the acidic medium. Okay, for the coagulation, for the coagulation of the casein protein, they requires the acidic medium. If there is an acidic medium, then only that casein proteins clumps together, and then it becomes only the solidified mass. Okay, so let's see. Milk plus curd means what happened? Whenever we are adding the 1 spoon of a curd in a milk, then what happened? It contains the so much amount of the Lactobacillus bacteria in it, which helps to form a curd. Okay, which helps to form a curd. Let's see. Milk plus curd. Next one, what I have written on the arrow? Lactobacillus bacteria multiplies. It started to grow on it. It started to grow rapidly. Next one, the milk become acidic. Very important step here. What happens? The milk become acidic when we add the curd in milk. Then the milk will be acidic. Okay, here we are creating the acidic medium. How we are creating the acidic medium? We are adding the curd into the warm milk. Then that milk become what? Acidic, which helps in the casein coagulates in the acidic medium. So here we are creating the acidic medium. Because of that acidic medium, what happened? The casein get coagulates in the acidic medium, and then it forms the formation of curd, and then we are getting the curd, or there is a process of formation of curd from milk. Okay, but let's see how the medium is getting acidic when we are adding the curd into the warm milk. Okay, after adding the curd into the warm milk, how the milk become acidic, let's see. So whenever we are adding the curd into the warm milk, then it already that curd contain the lactobacillus bacteria. So that lactobacillus bacteria started to break down the lactose sugar into lactic acid. Okay, so what we have done, we have added the 1 spoon of curd into a warm milk. Okay, and then that milk become acidic. Why it becomes acidic? Because whatever the amount of the curd we have added into the warm milk, that curd contains the one type of the bacteria, or which type of the bacteria, that is lactobacillus bacteria. Okay, so that lactobacillus bacteria started to convert the lactose sugar which is present in a milk. They started to convert the lactose sugar into lactic acid, and that is the reason the milk become acidic after adding the curd into warm milk. Okay, so see, this creates the acidic medium needed for casein protein present in the milk to coagulate. Okay, so that because of that acidic medium, that casein protein can get coagulate and then form a curd. Okay, so see here, I have written the process. Lactose sugar that is present in milk, which helps to convert the lactose sugar into the lactic acid, that is lactobacillus bacteria. It converts the lactose sugar into the lactic acid and then turns the milk acidic. Because of that acidic milk, what happened? The casein protein can get coagulates, it becomes solidified, and then we are getting the curd. Okay, so this is the formation of curd. Like that, the lactobacillus bacteria helps to make a curd. Okay, same way the paneer and the cheese can also get prepared with the help of this lactobacillus bacteria. Okay, now the next we can say that that is bacteria act upon tough meat and make it soft. Okay, and make it soft called tenderization of meat. Okay, so if you want to make a meat soft, then what we have to do, we have to perform the tenderization or process. Okay, what is mean by the tenderization? Means what happening, that certain bacteria act upon the tough meat, and because of that bacterial action, that tough meat becomes soft or tender, and that process is only called as a tenderization of meat. Okay, now the next one, use of microorganisms, we can see that is in the baking industries. Okay, in the baking industries, there are the so many cake, pastries, breads we are making in the baking industries. Okay, so certain types of the microorganisms also used in the baking industries. For example, we can say that yeast is a one type of fungi, which is also what? Microorganism. Okay, so that yeast is used in the baking industries to form a bread, cake and the pastries. Okay, so whenever we are making the dough for making the cakes and the pastries and the bread, in that dough we have to add some amount of the sugar and some warm water, and after that in that dough we have to add the powder yeast. Okay, we have to add the powder yeast. And then that dough we have to keep on the warm places. After some time, we can say that that dough is getting increase in a size. Why that happened? Why that dough is getting increase in a size? Because as we have added the yeast powder in the dough, what happened? That yeast started to do the respiration, and while doing the respiration, they escape out the carbon dioxide. Okay, so the yeast started to do the respiration, and from that respiration the carbon dioxide gas is comes out, which get fills into the dough, and the dough is getting increased into the volume. Okay, and that same dough whenever we are using to make a bread or cake and the pastries, and when we bake it, then what happened? That carbon dioxide is get escape out, it comes out from the dough, and then it makes the certain food stuff very fluffy and light in a way. Okay, so in this way, in the baking industries also certain microorganisms are using like that yeast. Okay, so this is all about what? Making food atom with the help of certain useful microorganisms. organisms. Okay, so in this way, which food items we can make with the help of the microorganisms? We can say that making of the curd or the formation of the curd. Next one, we can say that what? Making of the cheese and the paneer, then tenderization of meat and baking industries. Okay, so that yeast is can also used in our daily household practices also, that idli, dosas, dhokla, all these are the batters we are making with the help of the fermentation process. Okay, so that fermentation process is happens in the presence of yeast microorganism only. That yeast is helps to enhance the process of fermentation. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the useful microorganisms. We will meet in the next video with the next point. This is the time to tell you goodbye, and for today, thank you.